Well, that's the video that's gone viral, that's got a lot of people talking. In fact, there's been a lot of controversy in reaction to this. The man in question, who's been beating up these two children, the 16 and 14 year olds, says that what he did is right. He has to take care of things that happen in his home, and for that reason, calls on other bodies to arrest him is not the way to go. It is not biblical. In his view, people who say that are unintelligent and have low IQs. But really, what's happening here? Let's pay the thoughts of a psychologist. He is a senior lecturer at the University of Ghana's Psychology Department, Dr. Joseph Safi. He's also the National Secretary of the Ghana Association, the Ghana Psychologist Association in the country. Thank you, sir, for joining us today. You've seen the video yourself. What do you make of it?
I think first and foremost, let me register my greatest displeasure to what we just saw. And I guess that time has come for us to take a deep reflection of what religion is and the role religion is playing in Ghana's drive towards development. The first point to note in this is, does the pastor own these kids? Even if he says that they stay with me, can he really exercise certain control, and to what extent can he exercise such control?
If they are 16 and 14 year olds, if they were his children, could he have done the same?
The laws of Ghana do not accept that.
Flogging your child?
You can do that. Abuse is against the law. And I guess that's what the this domestic violence bill tries to address. You can't just flog a child, you can't just molest someone and say, well, that's my child. And especially when the person stays with you, these kids are not his own biological children.
He says adopted children.
That's fine, he's taking care of them. But let's come to the substantive case, and that is that I think that, and that's not to discount the fact that religion plays a heavy role in Ghana's development, but I guess that we need to take a good look at the paradox of religion. That on one hand, it's becoming a tool of violence, and people are hiding, you know, behind certain biblical texts and quotations and say, well, spare the rod and spoil the child. And they are really doing what is really dangerous to the mental health makeup of people. And there are others who say that, well, that's my home, and I hear that's what he said, that is his home. Well, if that is any argument to go by, then you can just be in your home and kill somebody after all. That is your home. That is completely not right. Point number two is that I guess that when people have made mistakes in life, we have to be careful the kind of punishment or the kind of behavior modification we want to prescribe before a group of congregants. What you are doing is that you are really inflicting perhaps irreparable damages on their self-image.
He says it was a prophecy. He saw it in the church room, that is what was happening. He called them out, asked them, and they confessed. And it was at that point that he took that action.
And these messianic tendencies from some new prophetic ministers would have to be interrogated seriously.
How do we do that?
Now, that's one of the things we're doing here.
How do we interrogate?
One of the ways we can interrogate is to tell people what we study and what we do and what we find out there, and to call on bodies that want to pick them on, human rights activists, to go out there and prosecute. For example, you see, when somebody starts giving an impression that my actions are driven by a higher authority that I respond to and that nobody can interrogate what I do, is dangerous. Now, the next thing we're going to see is that the person will say, okay, that's fine. Now, the next time I hear Jesus tells me, stop someone, once I hear he says so, I'll do it. And that's dangerous. Now, to me as a psychologist, what is interesting is the relinquishing of the self, okay, to someone who has some dramatic influence over people. Now, where is the self Where is the individual in this? There are people sitting there watching. There were others who were even laughing. What has gone wrong? Have they asked myself? So can't anybody in the congregation, in the leadership, draw his attention that this is bad? If you study cultic behaviors in most religious cults and abuse that occurred in some areas in the US, for example, one particular thing you find about them is that the leader has certain unquestionable posturing. And it's as if when you belong to a leader, you virtually you have relinquished your capacities of thinking. You've lost your reason. And when religion takes it to a level where you lose reason, then we have problems here.
You think this is moving into the realm of a cultic setting?
No, I think it's moving in there. There's no doubt. You see, what I saw and what I heard, for example, when he was flogging the girl or so, and then she attempted to run away, she said, no, I think she, what can we do, for example, and get all these religious leaders on board and say, okay, you can help us in here. But, there's a but here. The but is that until we have sanitized some of these services of some religious leaders, it becomes questionable to engage some of them. Now, the question is, if you have a leader like this who claims that I hear from God, and so when I hear it, I act, then it becomes dangerous. The next time he says that I have heard that God says I should slap you, God says I should knock you down, God says I should disallow you from doing this, you can do anything. I think that we're getting closer to cultic realms.
And for this fear you have, how do we deal with it?
Well, I think that we have various religious organizations and bodies in here. Christian Council is around, Ghana Pentecostal Council is around. I think that they should speak. I guess that we're just allowing things to just go that way. They should speak. They should speak up. The laws should work. Nobody's above the law in this country. And I think I just heard somebody saying that he wants to file a case for abuse. I think he should be encouraged. We should not go this way. You see, it foments a certain kind of ideology about religion, that religion really facilitates aggression and violence. And that's what we're seeing. I mean, some time ago, there was another case, for example, that was covered by your station, I guess the measure of Nentuka or so. People do all kinds of things under the name of religion. Religion is supposed to give people meaning. I mean, meaning to life and livelihood or living that is meaningful. I mean, that doesn't, you know, arrest the person, and not arrest the person, but that doesn't, you know, rob the person of what the person is. It doesn't, for example, disengage the person's faculty, mental faculty. The fact that you're a Christian or a Muslim or a religious person doesn't mean you must lose control of your faculties.
Of your senses. Okay. Yes. So one thing to bear in mind here is this. For the two who have been flocked, the 16 and the 14-year-olds, what kind of psychological effect can this have on them?
You see, in one of our studies that we have conducted in Ghana, and we are about to publish the results, loss of face. When people have lost their sense of respect, when people think that their sense of honor is dented, it is a major risk factor for depression, and depression has often been implicated in suicidality. What he did to this gentleman and the lady can really lead to self-deprecating thoughts. They are likely to feel they have been manhandled, and especially look at a number before a congregation, and this may lead to, for example, a sense of depression. They may have all kinds of anxiety-provoking thoughts, worried and bothered. I really can imagine what might be happening to them by this time. Everybody has said about their story everywhere in the world. What is it? They fornicated and they were flogged in church, in the presence of huge numbers of people. You don't do that. So definitely, I believe that their mental health, to a certain degree, is compromised.
Okay.
They are not going to be well. They are worried. They'll be distressed. It may start as just worrying, and then it continues and lingers, and then eventually maybe they'll be depressed.
Okay.
I think that they need support.
Would you be ready to offer that support? And by that I mean you're the Ghana Psychologist Association.
Of course, we will. We have people waiting. We have others who can provide services. We have done that the last time when there was this flooding in town, and people, you know, suffered some kind of damages. We provided services to them. And I guess that people who are going through this kind of religious abuses should quickly seek help. But let me just quickly put it out there, and this is not to speak for Ghana Psychological Association, but on my own level, that people should not relinquish their freedom to persons they can trust and to persons who will virtually hijack their freedom. It's dangerous.
But for these individuals, I'm not sure they were coerced to do it. They offered to go and they went to live with him as a doctor.
Yes, but I don't think that when we were going to live with him, they also signed that, we are ready to let him kill us, so to speak. I don't think that virtually that was what they were saying.
On that point you make about these two and their parents and not relinquishing your children or someone into the hands of a man like this, let's hear from the mother of the lady in question who was flogged today. Let's hear what she had to say about this incident, and then we'll continue the conversation.
Sebu shepu atiana, mikura sonde mwomeni ya nso siyano.
So that's the mother of the lady who's getting impregnated by the gentleman of the church, which has now become a matter of controversy. Now, in a nutshell, for those who may not understand Chi, the point she was making is that she got to hear of the daughter's pregnancy very late when she was rushing to church. So when she got there and this played out in church, in her view, she was very angry that the daughter had gotten impregnated. She didn't know about it. In her view, she will have even done a lot more in flogging the gentleman who impregnated the daughter, even more than what Bishop Obinim did at the time. Also, for those who are criticizing and saying that Bishop Obinim should be arrested for beating up her daughter as well as the gentleman in question, she may be provoked to rain curses on those people, invoke curses on those people, if that care is not taken and if people don't stop pushing for Bishop Obinim to be arrested. That's for the mother of the lady in question who has been speaking to one of you, Owusu Abuaje. Well, we're not done. I'll pick the thoughts of the psychologist in just a moment. But we've also been speaking to the mother of the boy, or say the man who's impregnated the lady in question. Let's hear from her as well, and then we can wrap up this conversation.
Tommy, I'm sorry, them fam.
Na unim se oba be man obi visa na wakoye.
Na minim. Na ya papa sunim. Nti ya sorry them na omo ho asam bae. E na obu om. Nti am po obu om na ye me de pa. Because as a kwala wo ni wo papa etie. Now ye de wo ko school. Sika kese akese aye tua ma wo. Wo nya nyini ye. Ejuma papa mpo wo nya start ejuma ye na wakoye se oba. Na onukura nkotena nche se eduro na anka bayo anu omunyina omuti fie ha obofo na ehwe omunyina odi eduro akoka nti anka nyame anya akire obofo na se onumu eduro nu na obewuto ha anka dia na gana fo nso beka nti no tumi nu die obofo wa right pa wa ya die ti mene nu ya dwen ya baako aya me de pa because ya papa no ya nini na yeti se bibi tu obi sesia obenya asam nti se omo ye ade ansa se omo ye a no straight omo e yepa because ye ya sorry dem ye we youthful bebre omo nyinyi ye sa life no omo nyina omo ye nti na nyam kupon ofa obofo so gwa omo se na omo a omo kae no omo besua nyansa nti no nyame onim ni oye onim ni oye nti ni a
sisi a watete se ye se police enche no
Dabi
mosusu omo kokot.
Dabi we enye police asambia because tama akwala no papa wu ya owo 9 years. E amene member bre no. Mebusia no kro obi anje me ne member ye bre pa. Tama ye ba ha no. Obofo onimu wo baby but oje mi ma me baby tena. E fa me mba te se ne mba odi omo kosu. Nti we enu enye mra. Me ma nkwa report obofo am obi ya because oye omo papa. Nti wat si omo a emre bia ni wo se ye nchi no ye ne mba.
Police for frail Cecilia then I beg.
Omo frail me ania me ka kire wono sa na meka. Omo papa no no. Me ankasa me papa no 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 hwe ye bibia ye tinifie hanso. Nti police chi no enye ye. Eya nemba. Nti akwan wo se omburo omo. Omo anye ye. Akwala no kura wo si ada ma nya ade fa che me. Se as a school boy me ko school a. Un hwe me wie ye na ma sa akonyim. Fa che ye ya bone. Nti no. But for our rights, say I want to know what because I'm only not in the
So you've heard the accounts of the mothers of the two individuals who've been flogged in this matter. Let's look at the thoughts of the psychologist now. You watched both videos.
Yes. So clearly, as I said, I think that there's no doubt that this is becoming a cultic movement straight away. Now, these parents have completely lost their capacity to think differently. And you can see it. The girl's mother says that, hey, I have 10 kids, and is but for the intervention of the bishop, I wouldn't have been able to take care of the kids. And so she would even go to the extent of invoking curses on those who have contrary opinion to what the bishop did. Yeah. And then the boy's mother also confirmed that. And if you look at cultic groups and movement, that's how it starts. They feed on vulnerable persons. So people who are vulnerable, who have gone through challenges, difficulties, and have left them broken, they step in there to provide meaning, solace, and help. And obviously they are right. If nobody stood in for them when they were in trouble, and the bishops stepped in, then of course they have sworn an allegiance for life, and they will defend him to the core, as they have just demonstrated.
Okay, now when you say that the Christian council should speak out, the charismatic council should speak out, should it end there with just speech? Because you're dealing with a matter where the police are investigating, the parents of these children are in support of the action being taken. I'm certain that even for the two who've been flogged, they may not even come up and openly say that we have been assaulted, let's deal with this. It complicates the whole thing. Does this not look like a Mission Impossible here?
not at all. Let me start from this angle. I think that theological unsophistication in this country is very high. People don't know their Bible. And that's why I think that first Christian council and religious groups should speak. Those who know the Bible should get into the radio station, television station, and they should saturate the real word of God in the airwaves. We need to hear that. There must be an attempt to break this kind of, this idea of, people stepping in out there and putting, junk out there, and people are just rushing for it. But beyond that, if anybody gets himself or herself involved in anything that is abusive, the law should pick the person up. I guess that he is not the first person. I mean, this similar thing is happening in East Africa and some part of South Africa. And the law should work. If he has broken the law, he must be made to face the law.
Okay.
But I guess that if we get Christian Council, if we get Ghana Pentecostal Council and other religious bodies coming out, I think that people are getting afraid of some of these things. Because I don't want anybody to insult me. Let's get over that. We need to address the issues squarely. And I think that we psychologists are stepping into this now. We have to make sure that religion becomes a tool of impact and blessing, not a curse.
Okay. I guess we'll leave the final word in this matter to Bishop Daniel Obinim. Mama, we spoke to him today. Let's hear from him, and then I'll pick the thoughts of the psychologist to wrap up this conversation.
But we need the human way in any so. We need to collect lawyer.
Where a lawyer would be in Kofon Sema on Jessica Crow Hall in the past?
We need to collect human issue. Because all your lawyer, your human charge, and I be a judge. Judge be a lawyer now. It means we be a sentiment for court 5 years, 10 years, not judging why. Judge need to take part A, lawyer could take part B. That's the judge. As a lawyer, who before as a lawyer, who be jinem ama ubi. Mabo court several times. Mabo court several times. I know the law. Before as a lawyer, who be kubi as mama no. You have to see the person personally. And yet at the same on air. You don't know the family people. Obama who can ask for a person defending you. You don't know him. Akala bema no person defending you. You don't know him. You don't know the parents and who need to see your follow. And Corona time in jail for 8 years. Me na mashu amua from infancy, from childbirth. Mashu amua me starting from infancy, kwa the pain 8 years. Bemani was 16 years. Obani was 14 years. Etin Corona kitoa ashono. Et na shofu fi a kempana begamai. Enti as a lawyer. What's the meaning of lawyer? Open dictionary, lawyer. If we are loyal to everybody, loyal to people, you have to loyal to every person. It means here one person's side view, then take it as a that angle, every free man. As a lawyer, what you are saying, you have to investigate. Say, hey, okay, when you ask my matter, I want to call Bishop Obinim to find out. Open the number, it's easier to find out because I'm on air every day. Open the numbers, you need to call TV show. Hey, I want to talk to Bishop Obini. Is that you know? Okay, give me Bishop Obini number. Get the now. Bishop Obini, I want to ask you this question. I'm a lawyer, so. What about this? Mama explanation na minim na machire maadwen e dia ma. Say say na semetie. Okay, Bishop, I want to see you personal and both of the family. Na me dia kola no me nso abrew. Your loyalty e ba dama, enye loyalty e ma hwehwe anim no adwuma. In fact, same nya adwuma. So what you say? Akola asebi o ma me papa Jimidi. Say na me kana hyase no. E wa dia fa me so san ya le. Na ma famo infancy, now my friend, 8 years. Last week, yeah, but I'm going to have them on the school fees. 76 million. Last week, yeah, I'm going to have my school fees. And not that, yeah, I promise you, I make ups any facial. My friend, I'm going to say that, Dachi Bino, every plan I'm going to have a plan or a brilliant, when it just are IT, you know. Even Dachi, you probably to say, Minia Bay out here, McKay, where you're ready to do. Oh, but me can also say, many times, many times, you chin. And you play, oh, me, you and me, Juman, Kukumasia, Kratema, and Colano Sosono, or Mutifi, for his obedience, so on Sosono, or Yemen musical side, and also put on now one would need some gift, or also Yaka, the Juman, to an also solo, a call out treating me could preach a chair about the marriage, a you know, a cross at the enchant doors.
Well, there'll be more on this interview. The extended interview will be played next week, Monday, on the AM show. So make a date and watch it in full. That interview with Bishop Daniel Obinim. I'll pick the final thoughts of the psychologist now to wrap up.
So I think that we have to understand that religion has the potential to be destructive and to foment violence and aggression. And at the same time, it is good. If we get to know how to use religion well, we can, for example, modify behavior in several dimensions. But I guess that where we're heading towards in terms of this story is dangerous, and that we have to call those who are using religion and abusing others, we have to call them to book.
You made reference to a certain case elsewhere that this could degenerate into. Which one is that? Is it a Jim Jones case?
Yes. I mean, history is replete with such cases where the leader virtually takes a messianic, you know, perspective. He has the sworn allegiance of all the people who he's leading. He's unquestionable. Dissidents are punished brutally and all that. And then eventually, Jim Jones Court in the 70s in the U.S., in Guyana, he gave cyanide-laced potions to his congregants. And they took, and close to 1,000 people died. I don't think that we have to wait until we experience some of these things. I think that leaders in this country, the law should work, and that for everyone who is listening and watching us, please, religion should not let you stop thinking. God wants you to think. Okay. Use your mind.
Thank you, sir, for your time today. That's Dr. Joseph Osafo joining us. He's a senior lecturer at the psychology department at the University of Ghana. I need mention that a suit has been filed today in court against Bishop Daniel Obinim by human rights lawyer Francis Xavier Sosu on this matter. We'll bring you more on this later on, but we'll pause now. We'll come back and bring you sport here on the Pulse. Stay with us.